10 Cats, Adrenaline Junkie, Jack Osborne, Rock and Roll Funny Man, Tim Minchin, and their team captain, Jason Manford. And facing them tonight, hide the cutlery, it's Uri Geller. Funny Woman, Holly Walsh. And their team captain, John Locke. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Cobb.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about surveys, statistics and this week, everything that we find scary. Did you know, for example, 9% of people say darkness is their biggest fear, but for members of the BNP, that rises to 100%. Between 500 and 1,000 baby tarantulas hatch from a single cocoon is one of the creepiest things you can whisper to your girlfriend during sex. King cobras can deliver enough venom to kill 10 people. Right, Jeremy Kyle, Piers Morgan, my girlfriend's mum, my girlfriend's dad, my girlfriend, Nick Griffin, Osama bin Laden, Anton DeBeck and Lulu. I know that's only 9, but I'd kill Jeremy Kyle twice just to make sure. And one of the biggest fears is the unknown, like, I know. Right, let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. We've teamed up with a leading polling organisation and they've asked the British nation what they find scary. It's our panellist's job to guess the British public's top 5 scariest things. Jason, Tim, Jack, what are they scared of?
Well, I think these days, for some reason, it's ghosts. Well, I don't know if people are scared of it. They like thinking about it and making crap television about it. But are people still scared of dead spectres and stuff?
I'm just scared of Derek Acora.
Can you imagine that? Like, dead for, like, hundreds of years, and then the first point of contact with, you know, alive people...
is a camera.
And then it's him going, all right, there he is, there he loves dick, and all that. You know.
Do you know, talking about Most Haunted, Derek Acora...
Yeah.
I think that show's been going on for 5, 6, 7 years.
Longer,
I don't think
yeah.
they've ever seen a ghost.
No.
They're changing the name to Least Haunted.
That show should be called Location, Location, Location. Because they can never find one, can they?
I do enjoy those shows because I believe in ghosts. I believe in ghosts. Most people believe in ghosts. How many of you believe in ghosts? Come on!
If you believe in ghosts, go... I mean, I tell you what proves there's no ghosts.
Yes.
Scooby-Doo. I watched 5,000 episodes. Every single episode started with rumour of supernatural activity. Every week, no ghosts. There was a man, a janitor, or a fellow who used to work in a disused mine shaft.
There's no way you can debunk Albert Einstein, who proved with the famous equation E equals mc² that everything is made from energy. Energy cannot be destroyed. Energy lives forever. Therefore, one
but
must ask,
no,
what happens
true,
to your energy when you die?
What energy,
what
though?
It goes
your energy,
into,
you go into the ground.
This is
then...
energy. This table is energy. This is not solid.
That's because it's plugged in. It's got lights on.
But then a car is energy, and when a car gets squished up and breaks down, is the spirit of the car still alive?
Absolutely.
That's the whole thing about Einstein saying how the universe was created, how it couldn't have been created.
So energy goes at every... So you've got the amount of energy...
Energy can't disappear.
No.
This is like a stoned conversation in a student hall of residence. So, like, what? Like, the table's alive. And, like, when you die, you're still not dead, man.
No,
you're just, like, out there, but nobody can see you! This on the news, man. This shit's fucking serious.
I did a séance when I was a student. One night, you know, you think, oh, this will be a good idea. Get the Ouija board out, and we got the glass, and it goes right. Oh, we've contacted a spirit, and it all starts shaking. And then he went, right, what is your name? And it went L H G L L H. And I said, oh, this is not working. And my mate genuinely went, what if it's Welsh?
I went on a Ouija board once. First time I ever went on a Ouija board. I've never done it since, but I spun it around and it spelled out the phrase, you have no new messages.
OK, let's have a look and see if it's up there.
Yes!
Back in the game.
It's actually easy to tell if your house is haunted. It isn't. Sean, Ori, Holly, what do you think people find scary?
Waking up in the morning seeing your spouse.
Waking up in the morning and seeing your spouse, that you think they find that scary?
Yeah, it's very.
Especially if you wake up and call her, hello, spouse.
How scared are you of that? Is that a genuine, like a... Ah! You wake up, oh, so it's you! Ah! Or is it just a, oh, it's you?
I'm the only one that does not get scared.
Of course not.
Really?
Well,
of course.
Well got out, Tom, there. You're the one, the one time I woke up with your spouse, I freaked out.
You haven't really got out of it there. You haven't really got out of there, Yuri, because what you've said is, yeah, everyone's scared of my wife. You're not married to Osama bin Laden, are you?
But I know where he is.
Do you know, can I just clarify one thing with Uri? You know that isn't him. What was Jack Osborne?
Yeah, what was,
but he's gone 1970s detective on us. OK, and what do you think people are scared of?
Probably terrorism.
You think terrorism? OK.
Yeah, I think that's number one.
Yeah? Terrorism. They don't exist. It's a figment of people's imagination.
So what does he believe in? No ghosts, no terrorism. What do you believe in?
Whiskey. Whiskey in the high seas. Treasure.
It's weird, isn't it, how stringent they've got with the, you know, when you go up to the airport now. I mean, we went on this holiday. My brother, he's only a kid, right? And they took it off him. He had a toy bow and arrow set. You know, the toy bow and arrow set with the little thing at the end, because it was like a weapon. And I thought, what self-respecting terrorist?
Are you worried about it? Does it worry you at all, Sean?
Well, what I found interesting is that the government have a sort of like system of warnings, don't they? And it says there's like, don't worry about it.
That is the lowest level.
You only find out about that when there has been either a thwarted terrorist attack. I'd like it every day. Like, you know, on the weather in the summertime, they give you the pollen count, air quality, UVs. What's the use of the pollen count? Who looks at the pollen count and goes, oh, better not go out? But if it said, it's going to happen any minute now. You go, I'm not going out. I'd like to know this kind of stuff. Like rucksacks. They could like five rucksacks. Five rucksacks. Don't go out. Stay in. I don't give a monkey's about pollen or UV rays. I know it's hot. I'm not an idiot.
So you're saying it should be 1 to 5 rucksacks should be the rating. That should be the system all over Europe. You just go, how many rucksacks? 5.
Right, stay in.
Kaboom. OK, let's have a look and see whether the threat of terrorism is one of the things that we're most scared of. Yes, the threat of terrorism is the second scariest thing. On the 22nd of January, the UK threat level was raised from substantial to severe after the police intercepted an email that said, mwah, ah, ah, ah. Terrorist threat levels range from low and moderate through to he looks a bit dodgy, all the way up to, I don't care if this does look racist, I'm getting off the bus. Jason, Tim, Jack, what else do you think people worry about? What are they scared of?
Getting old. I reckon it's that, innit?
Tell me
getting
more,
old.
Yeah.
I pulled out a grey pubic hair about 2 years
ago. I know, it hurt.
Yeah, grey one, and I thought, how are my balls getting older than my head?
They have been wrinkly since you were 12.
How do you know? I went to a 60th wedding anniversary. It was my wife's grandparents, and I did say to the granddad, I said, what's the secret? Thinking he'll have a really romantic answer. So what's the secret of being married for 60 years? He went, the hard part is staying alive.
Yeah, that thing.
But I looked into it, and so it's diamond. That's when it stops being good. So it's diamond, and then 80. Does anyone know what 80 years married is?
Like copper.
No, it's worse. Oak. And 90 is granite. Basically, they're trying to get old people to buy themselves coffins and headstones. That's what they're trying to do.
Holly, are you scared of growing old?
A little bit, yeah. Although you do get more seats on buses and stuff like that. There are massive advantages. I was on a bus and this really old woman got on. She was really decrepit. And she went up to this guy, was sitting down, and said, how old are you? And this guy was like 37. She said, I'm 84. Get up. I was like, she's invented human top trumps.
So people are very respectful of old people, like getting up on the... on the bus, and like nobody swears in front of old people, do they? And I love that idea that old people don't swear as well. Like, if you think about your nana living through the Second World War, at some point in the Blitz, she was stood at her window going, "Fuck it!"
I'm scared of is not aging myself, but an aging population. The population is getting older and older and older. We have more advances in medical science, so people will live longer, be a great drain on all our resources. And I think we should introduce euthanasia, but in a subtle, subtle form. So, for example, if you make the font on road signs very small, so the old have more crashes. Things like that, so we could just slowly get rid of them without actually rounding them up in stadiums and shooting them.
OK, let's have a look and see if it's up there.
Yes!
Back in the game, back in the game. Yes, growing old is the scariest thing. I'm looking forward to getting old because I've always wanted to be systematically maltreated in a large detached house on the outskirts of Hastings. OK, fingers on buzzers. What else are people scared of? Go ahead.
Is it, insects?
Ooh. Like creepy crawly type things?
Yeah. I actually find spiders quite horny. I don't analyse it, I just go...
Four. Look at the legs on that. There's loads of them.
Since you brought up legs, I did the first celebrity...
The first celebrity...
Celebrity Get Me Out of Here.
Oh,
and
yeah,
I was the first one to eat some bugs. And I couldn't chew it. It was so tough. So I swallowed it. And when I was walking on the bridge back to the camp, it started crawling up my esophagus. It was living inside me and it came up to my mouth and I had to spit it out.
That was probably its ghost.
This is a true story.
Don't they say, like, in your life you eat something like 40 spiders in your sleep or something? Mm.
They say that, but,
yeah, but
really...
Who's they?
Yeah, who's they? About... Mainly Uri. If you want to know how to deal with spiders, this clip tells you everything you need to know.
I've got a visitor in the house and she's up there on the roof. If I creep the camera around, we'll be able to see her. Oh, there she is. She's a wonderful critter, and it's mating season, so she's out in the prowl looking for a mate. They're huntsmen, and they move lightning fast. That's the way they catch their prey. I'm going to go up there and try and catch her with my best spider sense of this Chinese food container. I'll hand the camera over to my most faithful assistant to film this, and we'll see what we get. Oh, there's a great close-up of her. Look at her, isn't she beautiful? What a fine specimen. Can you see Daddy and the spider?
Yeah, I can.
Okay.
Daddy, careful.
Decided to get a bigger container because of the size of this one. I'll have to move really quick.
Amazing. That's fantastic.
It's just great the way he goes. Yeah, this is a little bit of confidence. This is how you deal with spiders. This is how this is done.
Spiders? Women don't like spiders, do they? Particularly women don't like spiders. And you know why that is? It's because they've got more crevices. Women have got more crevices than men. For the spiders to crawl into.
I like that. It's a diagram.
I've only got one crevice. And if a spider wants to go
that
up
we
there,
know of.
I'll take my fucking hat off to him.
Let's have a look and see if creepy crawlies are up there. Yes, creepy crawlies are the fifth scariest thing. Of course, the worst thing about being bitten by a poisonous spider is you're probably Australian. Join us after the break when we'll be finding out what else is in our top five scary things. Welcome back, Sean, Ori, Holly. What do you think people find
yeah,
scary?
Yeah, what do you think, Holly? You've got a broken arm, haven't you?
Is it... Yeah, I've got a broken arm, yeah.
How'd you break your arm?
I jumped off Worthing Pier in a homemade helicopter.
That's what... That is one of the worst suicide bids I've ever heard of.
I did it as part of the Worthing Birdman, where you used to try and...
Oh, yeah.
..to win a prize for, like, flying the furthest.
Yeah.
And,
I was following you on Twitter, and you were going... I'm really looking forward to this, and then didn't hear anything for about 6 hours.
Do you know what? I've got about 4 inches of metal in my arm. I am shitting
really?
Myself sitting anywhere near you, Uri Geller.
Yeah.
4 inches?
He could have...
What do you think doing the scariest thing. We'll get back to Uri's incredible talents later on.
Are there things where they scare you with the paper with the Tories about illnesses? Pandemics, they're called.
Oh, yeah.
Swine flu last year came out. They said, oh, we're all going to die. The British medical officer said that the minimum, they said, he reckoned there'd be 65,000 dead. In the end, so far in this case, he went like that, every minimum. Yeah, guarantee. That's in the bag. You've already won, doesn't affect what you've already won. It's 65,000 dead. So the undertakers, you're laughing. Only 457 people have died from swine flu in this country, which makes it statistically, it makes it more dangerous to be in the pretenders. I know that's not a band most of the audience here have heard of, but it's not that bad, was it? It wasn't that bad. They said
no. We've got taxi drivers with a higher body count than that.
Yeah, yeah. I had it.
What, swine flu?
Yeah, didn't need any vaccines. A couple of whiskies, sweat it out.
Well, I was worried about getting it, so I just ate loads of pork pies and bacon butties. I sort of immune myself with bacon.
Yeah, yeah. This sounds like a story you told at a Weight Watchers meeting. Yeah.
Well, no, at one point they said they listed all the symptoms of swine flu. They said, oh, it'll be this, and if you're sneezing, it'll be cold, and you'll be all. And then they said, some people won't have any symptoms at all. And I thought, fuck, I've got it.
But these flus,
whenever
the government says, oh, this is what's happening and you're going to die from this, it's actually not what you're going to die from. It's the stuff they don't tell you about which is going to kill you.
Yeah, pies and vodka.
Yeah, exactly.
Holly, are you worried about global pandemics?
I am a bit, but I kind of feel like we're a bit worried about germs in general. When I was a kid, if you dropped something on the floor, you just pick it up and blow on it, and then he'd eat it. That was fine.
Three-second rule.
Yeah, you...
Like, who... Everybody knows the three-second rule, but who came up with that? Like, did we have some sort of agreement with germs?
An actual doctor came up with that. Three-second rule.
Jimmy, this is in my pocket.
This is in your pocket?
24 hours a day.
Are you going to bend it?
No. I sleep... I sleep with it.
You sleep with
every
hands,
time I Joe. Shake. Every time
oh,
I shake
in.
Hands, I go...
That's disgusting.
Like that. Every time I go to the loo, I go like that.
I go out my cock.
Apparently, you're supposed to wash your hands and the length of the time it takes you to say happy birthday to yourself.
No.
Okay. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday, dear Sean. And then, happy birthday to me.
It always takes me ages because I'm always crying.
Yeah. It takes me ages as well because I do the Stevie Wonder one. Happy birthday to me. Happy birthday to me.
Okay, I can tell you that global pandemics is not in the top five. Like many people, my family was wiped out by bird flu. Oh, no, hang on, it was swine flu. Actually, no, they're okay. I just don't see them anymore because I'm famous. Okay. Jason's team, yeah. Another guess?
Clowns. What else do you think? We think clowns.
Clowns.
No one is afraid of clowns.
Everyone is. They're horrible.
How many people are afraid of clowns?
Yeah.
That's
loads
more
of people.
Than terrorism.
Do you know why I think people are scared of clowns? They're a bit like zombies. They're like the unfunny. It's because they want to make you laugh, and obviously they don't, but they don't give up. They keep going. There's nothing more scary than someone continue trying to make you laugh, you don't laugh, and their face is like this. That's really, really unsettling.
No, I'll tell you what, the one clown that does freak me out is at Blackpool Pleasure Beach. There's one at the front there, and it sits in a thing and it goes, ah, and it laughs manically all day. And we were there the other week, and they put a Blackpool scarf, like a Blackpool FC scarf around it. And my dad went, they didn't have that on when it was in League Two, the glory hunting clown bastard.
I can tell you that clowns is not in our top five. Interesting fact, clowns have to register their facial design to make sure that other sex offenders don't use it. Fingers on buzzers, what else is the nation scared of? Go on.
End of the world, like apocalyptic stuff.
Did you know that the ancient Mayans, they believed that the world's going to end in 2012?
The Mayans never thought the world was going to end. That's the hilarious thing. They were really good mathematicians, the Mayans, and they plan this shit thousands of years ahead. And 2012 happens to be where their calendar ends. It's like the equivalent of
having your guide dog calendar up on the fridge and turning December over.
No puppies! No puppies! We're all gonna die!
Are you telling me there's no puppies?
Einstein said that when the bees start dying out, then we'll die out 4 years after. Why don't they just start retraining wasps?
Retraining wasps?
Yeah. They look similar. Just get them out.
Yeah, totally works.
To do, little. Sort yourselves out. Go and start collecting honey, you bell ends.
I think that's...
do you know what? I love bees so much that if they could make them bigger, I'd have one as, like, a little pet. Do you know what I mean? If they could make them about this big, because they're dead furry, and I'd put a little cork on its sting. And then... Just have it around the house. I like them.
We're talking about the end of the world here rather than bees. Are you scared of that?
I'm prepared for it.
You're prepared?
Absolutely.
Well, you've already got the look, the Mad Max crazy look.
What I like about Jack's face is if you turned it round, it would look exactly the same the other way around.
You buy one of those bunkers outside Los Angeles?
No, no, I didn't buy a bunker, didn't go that far. But
Have you got a bunker under your house?
Yes, I do. It was there when I bought the house.
It was there when you bought the house? That's a hell of a thing for the estate agent to say. Also contains a bunker.
No, it's a great selling point.
Yeah, there's a bunker, there's a pyramid in the back garden, just in case.
You've got a runway.
No runway.
That's a big house, but you've got a runway.
I do have a helipad.
And do you?
Yeah, I do not own a helicopter.
Helipad, no helicopter. That's like having a bicycle shed with no bike. That's mental.
But what
my... That's like having a hat stand. Like, you haven't got a hat! That's like having a spice rack.
My excuse for having a helipad is that when you Google Earth, you see this big H, and that's my wife's first initial. Her name is Hannah. And so I did it out of love.
So she can find out where she lives?
Yes.
That's the shittiest birthday present ever. I've got you a helipad. Where's the helicopter? Not a helicopter.
Okay, let's have a look and see whether the end of the world is up there.
Yes! One.
Yes, fourth on the list is the end of the world. America is looking at sending shuttles into space to blow up meteorites that are on a direct collision course with Earth. But in the UK, we've got our own plan. I don't know what all the signs of the apocalypse are, but I'm pretty sure Jason Manford presenting The One Show is one of them. So those were the top five scariest things. My biggest fear is climate change, or to give it its official scientific name, autumn. Do you know we produce 48% more carbon emissions than we used to in the 1970s, but that figure could be halved if you just divided it by two. On the downside, sea levels are rising. On the upside, we all live a little bit nearer the beach. And some people fear that humans will create robots that will take over the world. But until they can build a Hoover that can get into the corners properly, I think we'll be all right. So at the end of that, I can tell you that Jason, Jack and Tim have 3 points, Sean, Uri and Holly have 2 points. The next round is Pick of the Polls. Let's have a look at the biopic of Uri Geller.
Joining us now in the Olympic Stadium studio, live from Sydney, Australia, is Uri Geller himself. The man who introduced spoon bending as a sport and brought it to international prominence. We've invited Uri to the festivities surrounding the first Olympic Games of the 21st century in order to conduct a special event just for the children of the world, using their psychokinetic powers. So, kids, get those spoons ready.
Kids, I know you've all been waiting to bend spoons with me, but just put that aside for a second. Now, for the sake of world peace, we're going to neutralize the nuclear weapons that threaten us all. Now I'm gonna count to three. And then we're all gonna say the word disarm. One, two, three, disarm!
Yeah! Go world peace.
Why didn't I see this on the news, man? That's like amazing.
Well, weren't you involved in some bit of disarmament?
Yeah.
What were you involved in?
Asked by the American chairman of the Foreign Relations Committee, Senator Cleburne Pell, asked me to join them while they were negotiating with the Russians to disarm nuclear weapons, and my task was to bombard the Russians, Yuri Vorontsov, to sign the nuclear treaty agreement. And I did that very successfully. They signed.
I think that deserves a round of applause.
OK, here's your related question. I think it's interesting. 43% of people believe in supernatural powers. Is that true or false?
Ooh, now.
Oh, well...
That's quite high.
Yeah, it must be much higher than that. What about Jesus?
No, no, I think Jesus is magic, and that counts.
OK.
Yuri, could you do anything that that convinces us of supernatural powers? Because I think most people... Before he does anything, let's... How many people believe? OK, that's none. OK. Why are we all messing about with... OK.
Take out.
It's a classic spoon.
This is what... This
Anyone
is
got
what
a syringe and a tie off? No, no, it's
OK, hang on.
Watch this.
This is what,
OK, watch that, OK?
Help me, and I wish it
That's not
to
work, sure.
bend.
Watch this. Whoa! Did you see that?
OK.
Sorry.
Wait. Hang now, wait, be wait. Serious. Come on. Hold this here. Hold it here.
Hold what there?
Hold it. Watch this now. Just give me a little time. There it's going. Watch this.
Hang on. Oh.
Oh, my arm!
Look, wait.
Oh. Oh, that is bullshit. Look at mine.
And my shoe came
Does
off.
Does everybody say
Look at this. Ah, Jim Lad.
The other thing that I was going to suggest was, because obviously people are watching this at home, is there anything amazing you could do for people at home?
I can tell you this, that if you people at home, which is my camera, is that number
camera
two?
Yeah, camera two. Go on.
You people at home, honestly, let's take this seriously for 1 minute.
This is one of the biggest benders in the world here. Come on.
Put the spoon on your television set. Let's give him 10 seconds to get a spoon from the kitchen.
OK, go and get a spoon.
Please.
I'll tell you what, I'm slightly magic as well. Look at this, and it's disappeared.
Jimmy, we gotta have. We have to be serious now.
I'm freaking people out, Yuri.
How'd I do that?
Oh my God! I've turned into Jason Manford.
I'm just gonna change those two back. Go now.
Everybody at home, place your spoon on your television set. All of us are going to say 1, 2, 3, go!
Okay,
and
what's
your spoons are going to jump off the TV at home.
Okay.
But turn the speaker up really loud.
Wait a minute.
Okay.
We shout, go. Okay, right. 1, 2, 3,
go!
Go!
Now, if your spoon did jump off, if it sailed across the room, email Jimmy.
Yeah, definitely email me. That'd be crazy.
Oh my God, Yuri! Look what it's done! My left foot is now my right foot! Oh my God! Oh! My right foot! My left foot! What have you done?
Stop being skeptical.
Why?
There will be thousands of people who will email Jimmy.
Yeah.
My God, my spoon jumped off the TV, and sailed across.
And one of those people one day might be the wife. Might be the wife.
Jimmy, are you?
OK, so back to the question. 43% of people believe in supernatural powers, true or false? What do you think, Jason? Go for the answer.
I would go, true. I think that's all... I think 43% is all right.
You think true? What do you think?
False. I think it's less than that.
OK, I can tell you that the answer is... true.
Woo!
If I had the power to bend spoons with my mind, I know what I'd do. Something much better with my time. So at the end of that round, it's 2 points for Sean's team and 4 points for Jason's team. Join us after the break when we'll be finding out what you think is the scariest job. Welcome back to 8 out of 10 cats, and the winner is the name of our final round. Here is your first one. Scariest noise.
I think it's John McCrurick unzipping.
is it the noise of your life support machine stopping and then the noise of a Hoover?
The Pope Mobile.
Is it the sound of a baby crying at, like, 3 o'clock in the morning and you haven't got a baby? Scary. Have you ever had that thing when you're walking and the echoes of your footsteps sounds like there's someone following you? So, like, every time you stop, they stop, but it's you.
Or that's one scary footstep on gravel and nothing.
Scariest noise at the Osborne's house?
That's a tough one.
Dad coming downstairs, presumably.
No, it's not. It's
that
not
tumbling
too...
noise.
Is it an eagle landing on your bicycle helmet? An eagle's claw. Imagine cycling on, you just hear.
What about? Is it
and then the sound of your board? Bicycle falling over as you get lifted up. And you see your bicycle getting smaller and smaller. And you think, this isn't any ordinary eagle, this.
Is it that, Jimmy?
Yeah.
The dentist drill has to be on there.
The dentist drill is on there. I think it's number 7.
Is it someone just like tapping on your window when you've gone to
that
bed?
That is it. Oh. Yeah, I'll give you that. Oh. Noise is scratching at the window. I remember one time I was around my ex-girlfriend's house. It was a cold, dark night, and there was a scratching at the window, and she opened it and said to me, what are you doing here? You've got a restraining order. Put your trousers back on. OK, scariest job.
Shark dentist.
The guys who, like, disarm bombs, that's gonna be a pretty scary job. Like, oh, fuck, I better get this one right. Shit.
Like, you know when they open a new, like, bomb disposal school, right? They get the fella to come in and cut the ribbon. He's like, ooh.
Is it the red one or the blue one?
Can I reckon a scary job? The guy who collects DNA on the Jeremy Kyle show. I don't want to look at those people other than put a swab near them. They probably just go, rah!
Have you done any scary jobs, Yuri?
Yeah, when the spoons attack me.
Good answer.
They do turn on me sometimes.
Everyone quiet. I want to hear this right from the start. tell me how does that happen? What do you mean?
They just attack me. They fly out of their, you know, cutlery drawer and navigate.
Does it sometimes happen when your wife is angry?
Operating procedure when, like, spoons just start dive bombing you? Do you, like, take the AK-AT gun and just start shooting them down like the Battle of Britain?
No, magnet. He's not staff, he has magnet.
No, but, yeah, like, what do you...
I mean, it's awful to be attacked.
Is it because of
spoons?
All their brothers?
It's awful to be attacked by spoons.
Yeah.
Now, that's a sentence you'll never hear again.
Give me the spoon.
OK, there you go.
Now, just imagine.
Yeah, just imagine.
60 spoons... coming your way, are you ready?
Yeah.
This, like that.
What do you do?
look at it. It looks like an art piece. You know, you put it in your mouth. It's created to feed your body. And did you know that the first spoon ever found was...
Down the back of the sofa.
In the pyramids.
No way.
Yeah. Unbelievable.
I have that spoon.
You have that spoon?
I have that spoon.
Someone sold you that spoon.
I have a Cadillac with 5,000 spoons riveted on its body.
Well, that...
Yes! I love this guy! Imagine this, Yuri. Right. You run out of your house, there's a helicopter landing on your helipad, but instead of rotors, it's spoons. And then you look, and there's not... anyone flying it, it's a spoon. And the spoon hand comes out and goes, Yuri, get in the helicopter. We're going to spoon land.
That is the getting attacked by spoons is the bad side of having psychic powers. Like, you can read people's minds, right?
As a matter of fact, the first reported attack of spoons...
If the questions aren't good enough, I'll answer my own questions.
But there's something also extraterrestrial about spoons.
Yeah, there's one. Right,
okay. They go in tax
now. Spoon. Look at Jimmy.
Oh, no, you're not
going to. Don't tell me this is not extraterrestrial.
Take his eyes out.
Or, I can feel, or, wait, I can feel wait, a sharp
or,
pain.
Or there's this one, very extraterrestrial.
Even more so.
I love that guy.
OK, scariest job.
Just the, whoever works in the cutlery department at the John Lewis near Yorick. I suppose an astronaut, that must be scary, or fireman.
It's not far away from that.
You have to wear something special?
Ballerina.
Special outfit? Underwater?
Frogman. Deep sea diver. Yeah.
That's the one.
Really?
Yes.
Yes, the scariest job is being a deep sea diver. You don't want to be in a job where everything has to go right for you to come home alive. How was your day? It was pretty good. Everything came together at the last minute and I didn't die. What are you doing tomorrow? Same again. Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are Sean, Uri and Holly have 3 points, Jason, Jack and Tim have one with 5 points. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience and to all of you for watching at home. Don't have nightmares. Good night.
Bruce is back and still hot in Die Hard 4 tomorrow night at 9:15 here on Channel 4.